In this video, we'll take a look at some of the major blood vessels. In this representation of the human body, you should be able to recognize a few major structures. First of all, the lungs, which there are two, but only one is shown here. The intestine, kidney, there are two kidneys, the leg, and the liver. If we take a look at the heart, we should be able to recognize the right atrium, the right ventricle, the left atrium, and the left ventricle. Okay, now that we have our orientation, let's take a look at some major blood vessels. You should be familiar with a few of these already. The blood vessels associated with the heart include the superior vena cava, which delivers deoxygenated blood from the upper parts of the body to the right atrium, the inferior vena cava, which delivers deoxygenated blood from the lower parts of the body to the right atrium, the pulmonary artery, which then moves the deoxygenated blood to the lungs, and the pulmonary vein, which returns oxygenated blood back to the left side of the heart, and the aorta, which then pumps the oxygenated blood out to the rest of the body. Many major blood vessels are named for the organ that they deliver blood to or take blood away from. For example, the renal artery delivers blood to the kidneys, and the renal vein returns blood back to the vena cava and then to the heart. The word renal means kidney. Another example is the hepatic artery. Hepatic means liver, so we know that the hepatic artery is delivering oxygenated blood to the liver, and that the hepatic vein is returning blood to the vena cava and then back to the right side of the heart. Some are a little bit harder to understand. The carotid artery takes blood up to our head and to our brain, and its counterpart that returns deoxygenated blood back to the heart is the jugular vein. The subclavian artery and the subclavian vein make a little bit more sense. Subclavian means below the clavicle. The clavicle is the big bone, the collarbone, sort of just below your neck, and on each side you would have one. You can feel them if you put pressure there. The subclavian artery takes blood to the arms, and the subclavian vein returns deoxygenated blood back to the heart. In the pelvic region, we have the iliac artery, which branches off the aorta, and it takes oxygenated blood to the legs through the pelvis, and the iliac vein returns blood from the legs through the pelvis back to the right side of the heart. And so far we've seen that arteries and veins come in pairs. An artery brings the blood into the organ, the vein takes the blood away from the organ and returns it directly to the heart. We have some exceptions in the body, and we're going to take a look at one called the hepatic portal system. In the hepatic portal system, the mesenteric artery delivers oxygenated blood to the small intestine, but there is no corresponding mesenteric vein. Instead, the deoxygenated blood goes directly to the liver via the hepatic portal vein. Now, you might be asking yourself why it does this, because this seems awfully inefficient. It would make more sense, or it might seem to make more sense, to have the deoxygenated blood go directly into general circulation. But at the small intestine, not only does the blood drop off oxygen, but it actually picks up the products of digestion, nutrients like amino acids, glucose, glycerol and fatty acids, nucleotides, and it makes a lot of sense for that blood to go directly to the liver rather than to general circulation, because the liver is the great processing organ. It's going to take all those micronutrients and process them. In other words, it will sort out the amino acids, perhaps convert them to other amino acids, get rid of any amino groups if the amino acids aren't needed. It can convert any of those products of digestion into glucose so that the blood has stable blood sugar levels. It can convert any of those products into fat if there have already been enough calories consumed. The liver needs to process those nutrients, and rather than putting them into general circulation where they become diluted, they go directly to the liver in high concentration so that the liver can efficiently deal with them. All that blood that enters the liver, whether it comes in through the hepatic portal vein or the hepatic artery, leaves the liver via the hepatic vein and goes back into general circulation in that way. Okay, so we've had a look at some of the major blood vessels in the human body, and you should spend some time memorizing them.